Everybody ready for a good time tonight? Come on, I can't hear you. Everybody ready to have a good time tonight? How many eat some fish?
Yeah.
You eat too much fish.
How many eat a whole lot of fish? How many feel it? Well, that's all right. I tell you, we'll get in the singing, we'll get the Spirit of God moving, and we'll just work it out of us. And if we have to shout, we'll shout. Run, we'll run. And we're here to have a good time tonight. And I want to thank all the cooks, everybody that fixed the fish, and all those that donated. And all this proceeds go to help the needy children for Christmas. How many years is this, Kelly?
Five.
Yeah, we were.
Everybody that's come out, and a lot of folks have went through it. I think Mike out there told me a while ago they fixed more fish than they ever had in 8 years. So we appreciate it. After a while, we'll take up an offering, and love offering that'll go towards that as well. The church here, the singers, nobody gets any of the funds, and all goes to help the needy children for Christmas. So we're glad you're here. We're glad you came. And tonight, we're just going to gather in here. Now, I don't want you to look at it as like this is an event or this is some kind of whatever. We're here to have church tonight.
Amen.
Amen. We're here to have a good time in the Lord. And the spirituals are here. Let me sing here in a little bit. And it's going to be great. It's going to be wonderful. Let's stand all over the building tonight. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. And we've got some very special singing that's going to come up in a little bit. And we appreciate it. Nick, you ready?
I'm ready.
You done laid that one to rest? Well, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's go to the Lord in prayer tonight. Heavenly Father, we come before your holy presence today in the mighty, matchless name of your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you, God, for allowing us another time to gather in your house to worship you and to serve you. And God, as we come tonight and gather and assemble together in your name, we ask you, Lord, tonight that above all, Lord, that every need that's in this place would be touched. Lord, that you would just move every mountain, lift every load, bear every burden. And above all, God, if there's any here that's never been born again, never been saved, I pray that the convicting power of the Holy Spirit would begin to touch them. And Lord, this would be the moment that their life would be changed forever. Lord, we know tonight you are the mender of broken hearts. You're the mender of broken homes. And God, you are full of compassion and grace and mercy. And Lord, we thank you for your great love tonight, wherein you love us. And God, you love us enough to send your only begotten Son to this wicked world to die for our sins. But he was raised again on the third day, and we can live forever and ever in a place called heaven. And Lord, tonight as we come to lift up that mighty name in song and in music, we pray that the mighty stirring of the Holy Ghost just fall down in this place tonight and move in our midst and fill us with your power tonight. Lord, even let a revival break out, God, in our hearts tonight. And Lord, that's why we're here gathered in one mind, one accord. Lord, we ask you to anoint all the singers, the music, everything that's to be done tonight. Lord, we do it to your honor and your glory. And we love you with all that we have tonight. And we praise you for your mighty presence in this house tonight. And we ask it all in Jesus' mighty name. And all God's people say, amen. Can you give the King of Glory if you can have a praise before you sit down? You know this old song, let's sing it.
Time is over, I'll fly away. Going to the moon.
And it was just amazing what was taking place and the horrific scene. And last night for about an hour and a half, I was watching old news broadcast, you know, the live news about it. And just replaying, and I sat there, and there was a few times I would sob and cry, and I was thinking about those firemen, those policemen that was running into that building,
amen,
putting their life on the line and sacrificing to save somebody. And so tonight we're going to honor that, all our first responders. We call them heroes.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
And heroes. Steve, you want to come on and sing? We said Wednesday tonight. You want to go ahead and get your band hooked in? He has a band, and have a band, we'll travel.
Yeah.
Go ahead. I just told him a hippie. I don't know why he's getting that set up. So we told Wednesday tonight we had some surprises. One of the groups, actually two groups, had canceled for this evening. So we had some surprises, and so tonight this is one of them.
All right.
Steve's going to sing. We got some singers from the church that are going to sing. Dolly and her assistant back there.
Yeah.
Assistant Dwight. Dwight, she told me to say that.
Yeah, I know she did.
They're going to sing a couple, and then the spirituals are going to be coming and singing. So I'm telling you, I'm ready for my cup to run over tonight.
Amen.
Amen. I love it. It'll get us ready for in the morning.
Yeah. Amen.
How many's ready for church in the morning?
Amen.
Oh, I'm telling you. So while you're doing that, let me say real quick, if you don't have a home church, we invite you here to Grace Union. We wouldn't dare, you know, I've been accused of being a sheep stealer, but I'm not a sheep stealer. If you don't have a home church, we invite you to Grace Union.
Amen.
Every service is just an explosion of the Holy Ghost in power. And I mean that, literally. And it's not about us, but it's all about Him. In the morning, it's not going to be any different. We have a word from the Lord that I believe will stir our hearts. We want you to come Sunday school, 10 o'clock, worship service, 11 Sunday evening service. At 5:30 Wednesday evening, Bible study at 6:30. Brother Tony will be preaching tomorrow night, ministering the word. And then tune in to 99.1 in the morning at 9 o'clock from 9 to 10. We'll be on there with the Grace Union Evangelism broadcast. So you don't want to miss it. Great things are happening. God is working today. Listen, I don't care if there's a virus. I don't care if there's diseases. I don't care if every demon in hell is at work tonight and unleashed. God is still on the throne. God is still God. He still has the power tonight. He still has the power to set you captive free. And if you don't believe it, I can't help it. Hallelujah. Even if folks don't believe it, that don't take away from the fact God is still God. Can you say amen? Praise God. Give Brother Steve Jackson a big hand to say.
I'm glad I'm saved. I'd like to thank the Lord for all that He's done for me. Praise the Lord. All right, we'll try to get through this. First time I've ever sang this song, so. Oh boy, here we go. I only shared the drum, the storm, but instead I thought Jesus, bring the rain.
Thank you.
pray for us. First time doing this one. Here we go. Every time I try to make it on my own, every time I try to stand, start to fall, all those lonely roads that I've traveled on, there was Jesus. When the life I built came crashing to the ground, when the friends I had were nowhere to be found, I couldn't see it then, but I can see it now. There was Jesus.
Thank you.
Taylor, you and Emily?
David.
Baby? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This church is blessed with a lot of wonderful singers and anointed singing. And, you know, I was thinking here a while back, how many realize tonight that gospel music is the only music in the world that makes sense?
Emily.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Gospel music is the only music
that makes sense.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The one in front of them.
I run out of words.
What?
I'm still in the miracle business.
You can't move it, Joe.
If you want me to slow down the word, just leave me a big old fish. Praise the Lord. Give a great string of singers a big hand.
Thank you.
If that don't stir your bowl, your spoons fell out.
That's right.
Amen. Amen, Joe.
Somebody else was Grace Union singer. All right. Praise the Lord. Dolly, if you and your assistant would make your way up to the front. Your lovely assistant. Praise the Lord. And when they get done singing, we'll get a big surprise for you.
Uh-oh.
And everybody's looking at me like, what in the world is he got next?
It's twins.
Thank you.
She's going to sing them anyway.
The first one. there to sing. And,
I'm going to need to see proof.
But
my trip over to Missouri, it was good.
You know, got to see some old friends, play some music, and I got to spend a lot of time with one of my nieces that I haven't spent a long time with. Because for those of you who don't know, I've had two strokes. So something like that, me driving all the way over there, that's a big deal for me. And I've been married twice, divorced, and I never thought I'd have to argue with a woman again. And that Garmin, that GPS on my car, I knew which way I was going, and they kept telling me to go the other way. I was right. Yeah, this brother back here in the back, he wanted me to do House of Gold.
Amen.
And
makes a difference. And my brother here has written the most beautiful song, and I asked him if he would do it today. So I'll let him tell a little more about it.
This is a song I wrote. Well, you know, God made us in His image, and I know He definitely made humor, because I'm full of it.
Hey, is this one that you wrote? Okay.
Yeah.
Just making sure.
Yeah, this song was actually on the charts for a while. It's been on quite a few years ago, but I had a song on, what's the name of the record? No, it doesn't matter. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Well, that's why I'm thinking so hard, so I don't tell the wrong thing. But anyway, it stayed on the charts for almost a year in the country gospel section. Yeah, that's what it was. Mindy. Yeah. For you, it's duh. But I used to go, and I've never been a veteran, but I would spend my time ministering through song. And there is a veterans hospital not far from Springfield, Missouri, that when I lived in Branson, I would go up there, and I got to know a lot of those fellas up there. And you know, it's something else. We don't realize the gravity of going to war and losing both your legs and your arms and your ears and your voice. Being able, and all you can do is lay in a bed the rest of your life. You know, I used to think that sacrifice was giving your life. You know what? In this case, I would rather go on the head than I would lay there all those years. But you know what? I got to thinking about those folks I met, and I wrote this song for them. I haven't sang this in a long time, so I hope I remember the words. Does a whippoorwill sound like? It's been so long. With your hands, can you show me? My hearing's gone. You know I was a soldier in the
The spirituals are getting ready to come and sing in a few moments. But we're going to break a loose something on you just right quick. Boy, you see a motley crew gathered here.
Lock the doors.
Would it be all right? You know, we got a lot of singers in this church. And we got a lot of preachers in this church. It's hard for you to leave in a wrong way with so many preachers. But not very many preachers have a preacher quintet. Was that what that was called? Five of us? Just a bunch of preachers. Would it be all right if we do a little bit of a song today? Would that be all right if the preacher sang?
Praise
the Lord. I could see the faces drop. And that's a good thing, because I tell you, in my opinion tonight, I believe we have one of the best Southern gospel groups on the circuit tonight. I really believe that. I mean that with all my heart. I have worked with these guys numerous times over the years, and they are the real deal. And I'm going to tell you something. I'd rather hear singing that is anointed by the Holy Spirit that comes from the heart than I have seen people get up and put on a good entertainment show. Amen. And tonight we've got a group that is anointed, and I'm glad they're here tonight. And I want you to give them a big hand as they come to sing tonight. The Spirit to the Lord.
We didn't pay Joe very much to say that. Not much.
The bill's coming.
Well, Joe, I'm glad you got up here, because those guys that sung were really good. I'm glad y'all sung, that you sung the pointer. That helped a lot. I appreciate that.
Oh, Now Made sure to point out that he told his GPS that she was wrong. That may be why he's been divorced twice. I got about having just saying whatever comes to mind. We sung over at Burksville one night, or out in Cumberland County. The preacher was there, and he said, "Oh, I used to come see y'all sing at Dale Hollow. I just loved y'all. Y'all was fantastic." That was 15 years ago. I was there. Oh, well, you didn't like us very much. You hadn't been to see us for 15 years. We've never been back. I don't know why. These two. Hey, y'all doing? We started out, we were singing this song. And we probably may have done it the last time we was here. Their daddy was playing the piano for him. And he said, "Daddy, you got to find a track for that." So we did, and they still let me sing a little bit on it with them. But this song says, today, "One Glorious Moment of Fame."
Oh,
ever since we, on our last project, we recorded On Time God. And ever since we've done that, when we would set up, rehearse, when we got everything, equipment set up and everything, Audrey would come up and she would start to track and she would sing that. So she's finally somehow talked Marla into letting her sing that with her. So we've been doing this a few weeks. I don't know, well, she seems to have that way of, her and Marla are a lot alike. They just seem to always get their way. I don't know. They're both the youngest. Even though they're twins, this is the youngest, and you can see. So she always seems to kind of get her way, but. All right, I'll do this right here.
Yes, he is. Tell Marla, I didn't know you could sing. But, you
enjoyed it. You know, it's amazing how that things don't always go the way you planned. And it's like the song says, he's right on time. And regardless what happens, it works out the way that he had it.
That's right.
You know, I love that too, to cancel maybe and something. We could even cancel and you'd still be great. I tell you. With a blessing, and I just got blessed just sitting over and listening to everybody. And, but you know, it's so good to be in God's house.
Amen.
So, and Kelly was talking about we were in Richardsville last week, and everybody there had on masks. And Kelly said, you know, it'd be nice if everybody just put a smile, draw a smiley face or something on their mask so we can see everybody smiling with Miss Brown.
Somebody put it on upside down anyway. A couple weeks ago, we sang, and Joe was there up at Camel Field, and he requested this song before we sang, so I really wasn't paying any attention to what he was doing, and I rolled into it, and I said, we had a request, and I'm going to do this song, and by the time I hit it, now look back where Joe was at, he had somebody down praying with him. So we're going to do it again, Joe. Now, if that means you need to get somebody down and pray with them, that'd be okay. But if you don't listen to it this time, I'm going to let you know we're doing it before we do it. It's an old Happy Goodman song that says you better hurry up and get ready to go.
Rest is gone, I'm on the big path, up beyond the blue sky. It must be so wonderful that there's an immortal life. We will soon be coming again from this heavenly throne. We shall be the circle of land and the flaming soul. You better hurry up. Get ready to go. You better hurry up. No time to be slow. Give your heart to Jesus today, oh, I wonder if you let him wash your sins all away. He's the only one to choose. Do not wait until it's too late. Let him be your true guide. First, his bright gate is to stand open wide.
Hurry up.
Yeah.
Get ready to go.
Hurry up.
No time to be slow.
If you want to ride in the morning cloud, we can see your enemies coming down.
Hurry up. Get ready to go.
Hurry up.
Get ready to go.
Ask that same question.
And I've been down that long road. Oh, but looking back, I now can tell you he's always let me know there is hope. So on, Lord, there is hope. God sent me here to tell you there is hope. Those
two young guys something to eat for lunch. And I said, okay. So I asked them if they liked hamburger, french fries, or whatever. And they said, yeah. So I told them, I said, well, why don't you, I forgot it ready. I told them, I said, well, I got it ready. I said, you're welcome to eat outside, or you can come in my house and eat. And they said, oh, we'll come in. So we all sat down around the table, and I asked him if he wanted to say the blessing, and he did. He prayed the longest prayer. It really just blessed me. And we sat there, and we talked about the Lord, and he said, you know, if no matter where you go to church, you know, it doesn't make any difference. And I said, you've been in lots and lots of places, a lot of states, and a lot of different churches. And I said, some, it does a little bit different as far as their service, but God's always been the same. You know, they blessed me all day because they kept talking about it. My sister said, it took them forever. And I said, because we talked too much. I think. Mark said, afterwards, I was telling her, and she said, well, you probably talked to them today. And I said, hey, when people talk about the Lord, I will talk to them. So, but, you know, God just sends the right people at the right time when you need. Isn't it a blessing? So when God tells you to do something, do it. Because you don't know who you're blessing or how much blessing you're going to lose people, not only yourself, but somebody else too. She's talking about me talking too much, okay. But, you know,
you just all said yeah, and that was it. You wouldn't argue about that.
We're not going
to keep going. We'll do one more song, and I know Marilyn wants everybody to come up, and we'll get everybody up and maybe God Bless America and see if we can get through that. But we'll leave you with this one if we can get through it. There it is. Y'all hear that all right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Aren't she there for you? You know that name. When the Lord shall come and so away. And if you're mighty, striving one night, you shall wear a golden crown. Aren't she there for you? You know that name. When the Lord shall come and so away. If you're mighty, striving one night, you shall wear a golden crown. I'm golden crown. I'm golden crown. Sing the golden crown. Sing the golden crown. I'm golden crown. I'm golden crown. Sing it for each night and time. In the baby word. Golden, 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 golden.
That's involved, from veterans to first responders,
They're just good old American people. I'm glad, still glad to be American.
Amen.
Still glad that, God's still on the throne. And you can look around today and you can see all the things. It don't take much to see the things that are wrong with America. But just like if your preacher stood every day and told every Sunday and told you all the problems and the things that you've done, and he didn't give you the solution to take care of that, there would be no need. And the solution for America today is still Jesus.
Amen.
It's the same as it was years ago when America was first founded. It was founded on God's word and God's plan, and that's what it'll take to get us back there.
Well,
this is one I wish we had got together and practiced a little, because I don't have a clue. We can pick a key and go with it, but I don't know.
You know, we were at the Little Joseph, everybody remember Rockwood, Jack and I was at the National Cortex Convention in Louisville, and we were on the bus, and as you know, things go over just about every few minutes, and when this happened, it was like just silence. Nothing. It was so quiet, and it was such a weird feeling to think of what had happened to our country. We were praying, and I don't think we could ever know that the prayer of our country. You know, the Lord says it.
Something you're going to wait for a long time. But this Patty said a while ago, God said, if my people, and so tonight it's up to the church to be praying, lifting up the bloodstained banner, declaring God's word, declaring his mighty works, the demonstration of power of the Holy Spirit. And I appreciate these folks, I really do, people like David over there, and who went over, fought for our country, the freedoms and the rights that we have to be here tonight. And we got people that don't even understand what our life's about. They would just love to do nothing but to burn our country down. But I got news for the devil and all his minions and all of the devil's army. There is a blood-bought, born-again church that is waving a blood-stained banner that's stopping with the gate, that's making a recession now. And we will not let this thing go over. As your prayer and praise, as you sing God Bless America, I want you to sing it from the depths of your heart, like you want God to reach down with his mighty hand. I want to tell you tonight, there ain't but one thing that's going to fix this, and that is if the church get ignited with the fire of the Holy Ghost, get set on fire for revival, and begin to come out of the spirit of fear and bondage, and has crippled much of this country, and began to stand up for the God of heaven and earth. Stand up for the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We will not let the devil have our children. We will not let the devil have our country. We can have our children. We can have our grandchildren. So tonight we pray, God bless America. To the west, from the north to the south. Lord, that we God, we pray for our neighbor churches, Lord, that's all around us. And God, we pray that even if it has to begin here, let that revival spark. Let that revival begin with us, God. That the flames of revival would be like a wildfire spreading across this community. That we would be a city set on a hill, a light that shines brightly, radiating, God, from heaven. And God, we ask you, Lord, to touch our children, our grandchildren that are growing up in this place. Help us as parents and grandparents to show them the right way, so that, Lord, they'll never depart from it. And God, we love you. Right there where you are standing, and if you're seated, just tell the Lord you love him. Just right there where you are right now, Lord, we love you. Nobody could ever do for us what you've done. Lord, we love you. Thank you for that marvelous plan of salvation. It's been made available to whosoever, even to the vilest sinner, that can come down and break every chain and set them free. And here the Son is set free, is free indeed. I thank you for that precious blood. And Lord God, we are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth. Lord, we thank you. There's a better place prepared, a better place that's waiting, that we're here just for a little while. But we're getting ready, Lord, to fold up our tents and move up out of here. Thank you for that promise. That this world is not my home. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God, for this service tonight. I thank you for blessing us, for smiling upon us. Lord, every home and every place that these funds go to tonight to help these needy children, every pocket that every dollar goes in, God, they may not even realize it, but I pray they'll feel the mighty presence of the Holy Spirit. Yes. They'll feel the anointing, God.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, let each home know that they are loved, not only by your people, but by you. And we love you tonight. And we thank you for everything. In you alone we live and move and have our being. Thank you, God. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty holy name. Amen. 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 Give the King of Kings, come on, with all your heart. Hebrews 10:25, for sake not the assembling of yourselves together as the manner of some Israel, but you see the day approaching. Now, maybe you can't. I see the day approaching. Somebody said the birth of us. The Bible don't say that. So we gather and we assemble in the name of Jesus, trusting him, and he honors that. If you don't have a home church to attend, we invite you here to Grace Union in the morning. Sunday school, 10 o'clock, worship service, 11. Tomorrow evening, Brother Tony will be ministering, 5:30, Wednesday evening, 5:30, 6:30. Let her know, Catherine. I tell you, tonight.